Now that you have Office 365 set up, you may want to decide to use it for email. You can obviously have email as a cloud-only option, where the mailboxes sit in Office 365, or you may have on-premise Exchange or Gmail, and you want to migrate those mailboxes into Exchange Online. So here we need to go to the admin section, and one of the options down the left-hand side is to click on Setup, and then click on Data Migration. If you're a small school with only a small number of mailboxes, you may be able to upload PST files into Office 365. But you can also use Gmail and also migrate from Exchange. If you have on-premise Exchange, you will need to be able to configure a hybrid mode, which you can do as long as you have Exchange 2010 and above with the latest service packs. If we look further down the page, Microsoft actually provide guidance. So if we click on the Gmail option, there will be a step-by-step process for you to go through that shows you how to get your mail and contacts out of Gmail and into Office 365. As you can see, it's a step one, step two, step three process. All you need to do is click on next, and it will guide you through all of the steps you need to take to get your Gmail into Office 365. If we go back to the main admin section and click on Exchange, you can see there is a Mail Migration Advisor. If you select this, it'll help you and guide you through how you can migrate your email. If you already know what you're going to use, then you can see on the right-hand side, there are guides to set up hybrid. Hybrid is supported in Exchange 2010 with the latest service pack and community update, and also 2013 and 2016. If we go into the Exchange console, you'll see that there is an option for migration. This is where you will see migration batches and the mailboxes that are being remotely moved from a hybrid Exchange configuration. You need to have a migration endpoint, which is normally the same server you would use for Outlook Web App. So you're normally your client access server. You will require SSL and certificates so that the mail can be migrated securely. The hybrid configuration that you can run on-premise will deal with the creation of all the connectors and the settings required.